Students, in this video, I am going to show you source transformation technique. So first of all, we will understand types of sources. So we can say energy source as a common term. It can be voltage source or current source, right? Now I am talking about independent sources only. So here I am going to discuss how to convert voltage source into current source or current source into voltage source in a circuit. So first of all, we will understand about voltage source. So you can say that ideal voltage source does not have any internal resistance, because if the voltage source is like 12 volt voltage source, so it should supply 12 volt only and there should not be further voltage drop across it, and the load should get constant 12 volt supply. So ideal voltage source has zero internal resistance, that you can say, but practically it has some resistance. For example, if 2 ohm resistance is there for 12 volt battery, so you can show resistance in series with the voltage source. So in case of voltage source, we always show resistance in series with the voltage source. And now about the current source. So symbol of the current source is like this. This arrow shows direction of current, and ideal current source should provide constant current to the load, right? So its internal resistance should be as high as possible. So you can say that for ideal current source, the internal resistance should be infinite, but practically it is not like that. So now here you have 12 volt voltage source with internal resistance of 2 ohms suppose, and you want to convert that into current source. So how can we convert? This is your voltage and resistance is given and voltage is there. So by using Ohm's law, you can find I is equal to V by R. So voltage is 12 and resistance is 2. So you can say it is 6 ampere current source. And resistance you have to keep as it is, there isn't any change. So you can say that 6 ampere current source in parallel with 2 ohm resistance, that is equivalent to 12 volt voltage source in series with 2 ohm resistance. Now similarly, you can do opposite also. If current source is given like 6 ampere in parallel with 2 ohm, and you want to convert that into voltage source, so what you have to do, you have I and R. So you can find V using I into R. So 6 into 2, that will be 12 volt in series with 2 ohm, as you can see. So in this way you can convert voltage source into current source or current source into voltage source. Now I will take one example so that you can understand in a better way. This is 28 ohm resistance. Here you have 4 ohm resistance, and here also you have suppose 4 ohm resistance. Here you have 5 ampere current source and here you have 10 ampere current source. Now the question is, you have to find current through 28 ohm resistor using source transformation technique. So here you can say that there are two current sources over here, 10 ampere and 5 ampere. So we have to convert these two current sources into voltage source. So this is one combination and this is another combination. So we have to convert both sources into voltage source and then we have to simplify. So in the first one we have 10 ampere current and 4 ohm resistor. So voltage is equal to I into R. You can say 10 ampere into 4. That means it is 40 volt, first voltage source V1. And this side is, suppose right hand side you have V2. So V2 in that also you current have, the equation is same, I into R. The current is different, it is 5 and resistance is same, it is 4. So 5 into 4, it is 20 volt. Okay, now we have to replace these two sources with new source, that is our voltage source. So I'm just removing this circuit. So in case of voltage source, resistance is in series with the voltage source. So the new circuit that will be like this. Here you have 4 ohm resistor in series. Here also you have 4 ohm resistor, that is in series with voltage source. And this voltage source is 40 volt, 20 volt as V2. Now this direction you have to see that 10 ampere was upward direction and here the 5 ampere was downward in direction. So wherever the arrow head is there, that at that place you have to put positive plate of the battery. So this will be 20 volt will be positive plate over here and negative over here, and this will be positive over here, negative over here, like this. Now the circuit is simplified. So I'm again drawing the circuit over here so that you can understand it in better way. This is 28 ohm, this is 4 ohm, and here you have, sorry, this is positive plate, this is 20 volt battery, and this side you have 40 volt battery and it is connected like this. Now we want to find current flowing through 28 ohm resistor. So suppose we have assumed that the clockwise direction current is flowing and it is I. Now you can apply KCL in the circuit, Kirchhoff's current law. If you do not know how to apply KCL, then go to that video. The separate video is there. So positive, this is negative to positive. So 40 minus current I is flowing through this circuit. So you can say minus of I, 4 plus 28 plus 4, and minus to plus, so this is plus 20 is equal to 0 you have to put. Now 40 plus 20 means 60 is equal to I, and addition of 28 plus 8, so here you will get 36. And when you want to calculate I, so it will be 60 divided by 36, you will get 1.67 ampere. So in this way you can solve examples of source transformation technique in which you have to convert either voltage source into current source or current source into voltage source. Thank you.